الحمد لله القائم على كل نفس بما كسبت، الرقيب على كل جارحة بما اجترحت، الذي لا يعزب عن علمه مثقال ذرة في السماوات ولا في الأرض تحركت أو سكنت، المحاسب على النقير والقطمير والقليل والكثير من الأعمال وإن خفيت. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله المتفضل بقبول طاعات العباد وإن صغرت، المتطول بالعفو عن معاصيهم وإن كثرت. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله عمت دعوته المباركة كافة العباد وشملت وأنارت بها الأرض وأشرقت، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله صلاة بالسلام عليه اتصلت. ثم أما بعد، servant of Allah, know that the repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mandatory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And he said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. And he said, وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to ask for forgiveness. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Sahih Muslim, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ فَإِنِّي أَتُوبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ فِي الْيَوْمِ مِئَةَ مَرَّةِ. And in another speech he said in Bukhari, وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ فِي الْيَوْمِ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ سَبْعِينَ مَرَّةِ. That means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than 70 times a day. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who we know that all sins has been cleared. What about us? Repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a mandatory, brothers and sisters. We have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from each of our sins that we did, even is it small or big. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is leave the sins that we did, or do whatever, or running so far from doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to us not to do. As all worships, there are conditions to accept this worship. So the repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are many conditions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَصُوحًا. التوبة النصوح is the sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only repents, the sincere repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our repents to him subhanahu. There are two types of repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of them, if we did the sins between us and between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there are three conditions. First of all, we have to leave this sins. We have to leave it forever. Second, regret that we did that distance. Regret that we did distance. So we have to feel sad that we did this sins, and we have to wish not to do it again. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الندم التوبة. Regret is repentance. Third one, we have to make sure that we don't return back to this sins again. We have to recharge our faith and do whatever we need to do to make sure that we will not do this sins again. Second case, if this sins between us and others, other people. Like, for instance, somebody stolen money from other, or somebody swear to others. So we have to go to this guy and give him his money or ask him for forgiveness that we said this about you, and we ask him for forgiveness with the three previous conditions. So we have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by to these types. All of us know that the doors of repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are open every time, every day, except in two cases. First of all, if the soul comes to the throat of the human, anybody, that means if he's like near to dead. قال تعالى وليست التوبة للذين يعملون السيئات حتى إذا حضر أحدهم الموت قال إني تبت الآن. That means in the time of death, the repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will not be accepted. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن الله يقبل توبة العبد ما لم يغرغر. That means Allah سبحانه وتعالى will accept the repentance to him unless his soul becomes till his throat. So that means he is almost died. The second time, when the sun rises from west. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام من تاب قبل أن تطلع الشمس من مغربها تاب الله عليه. That means whoever asking for repentance for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the sun rises from west, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it. After that, no. So brothers and sisters, pay attention for each sins that you about to do. Don't do any sins and say this is small sins. Nothing small to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask us to do, we have to do. And all what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask us not to do, we have to prevent doing these sins. Some people said for himself, I will do this sins, then I will repent again. I will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance. This is not right. This is one of the ways of Satan. It's old fashion of Satan's way to do to make people doing sins. Who knows that when after you do this sins, you are able to asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to repent. Who knows that? Nobody know. Maybe the death will come and take your soul. Maybe you cannot do this for any reason. So this is, I mean, not a right way to do sins and put in your mind that you will repent after doing this sins. No, this is not right. Also, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كل أمتي معافى إلا المجاهرين. He means that whoever doing sins in public, that means he bringing the punishment to himself. Doing sins in public, like somebody drinks or somebody doing any other sins in public, that means that it's like free advertisement for Shaitan's way. Shaitan's way. So everybody will look at him and say, okay, this guy doing this, nobody tell him anything, nobody. And everybody try to follow him and to do whatever he did. Whatever, when anyone doing like what this guy do, he will get all the senses that they did because of him. So doing senses in public is prevent. And this will bring the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to this guy and all of our society. Some people, because they are doing a lot of senses, they think that they are already in hellfire. There isn't any way to return back to the right way. Then they think, no way to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance, and they forgive up from forgiveness and repentance to Allah. For this people, we said what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called this call for everybody. He said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ أيضا, also he said about Jacob, وَلَا تَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Also he said, وَمَنْ يَقْنَطُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ إِلَّا الضَّالُّونَ. So no give up from asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. No give up from asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repentance every day, every time, after each sins that we did. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إن الله عز وجل يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala waiting for everybody to do repenting to him subhanahu, to ask for forgiveness after each sins that we did for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. That means whatever you have of senses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us all of these sins. Just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do the sincere repentance to him subhanahu. On the other hand, there are some people who's doing all kind of senses, thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor al-raheem. He is the mercy, He have all the mercy and he will forgive us, all of us. We said, yes, you are right. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has the mercy and he can forgive us. But also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قال تعالى نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن after that he said وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. Yes, I do forgiveness. I accept the repentance, but also my punishment is really hard. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have a mercy and he can forgive us if we ask him. And also if we not able to do that or not willing to do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a punishment. So we have to be careful about our senses and about our whatever we do. So if you say if you see yourself that you are almost like give up from forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no, remember what we said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع يدعون ربهم خوفا وطمعا ومما رزقناهم ينفقون. That's mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will that's mean we have to be in between the fear and that means we have to be in between the fear and the hope, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه من كل ذنب وخطيئة إن ربي غفور رحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ثم أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم said كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون. That mean when we created Allah سبحانه وتعالى give us the ability to do this any sins, and Allah سبحانه وتعالى give us the option that we can repent to him subhana. So we have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at every time after each sins that we did. In Muslim, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said لولا أنكم تذنبون لخلق الله خلقا يذنبون فيغفر لهم. That mean Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put this thing in our hearts, in our souls, so we are able to do sins, but we have the option to repentance, to asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said inna Allah yuhibbu at-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahhirin. That's mean whomever doing repents, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his repent. And he said at-tawwabin, that's mean he repents, he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. He repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means it's continuous verb. So we have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every time after each sins that we did. Servant of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can clear our senses by the sincere repentance to him subhanahu. And also, this is one of the causes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us this forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith Qudsi, ومن لقيني بقراب الأرض خطيئة لا يشرك بي شيئا لقيته بمثلها مغفرة. That means whomever doesn't worship other with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he did other sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us, will forgive all of his sins. Also, one of the things that clears our sins, saying salam in between all of us. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Sahih in Tabari, إن من موجبات المغفرة بذل السلام وحسن الكلام. So I mean spread salam in between all of us, that will clear our senses. Also from the worships that we did, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clear our senses. He said
وأقم الصلاة طرفي النهار وزلفا من الليل إن الحسنات يذهبن السيئات ذلك ذكرى للذاكرين.
That means whatever you do any sins, go directly and do any other good thing, any good worships, do charity, help somebody. Help your parents, help your friends. Do anything that you think it's good, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will clear the sins that you did. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. That means whatever you did, any sins, go direct and do a good thing, so the sins will be cleared. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about wudu and about tasbih and about hajj and umrah and fasting, all of these kind of worships, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. So please try to do your best doing these things. There are some benefits from repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will return back to you in here in this earth or in the life after. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ.
So repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you. Also, repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us becomes better and better in our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ.
And also, repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking for forgiveness, will make the punishment so far from us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ.
That means if you always doing for forgiveness, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness and repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not punish you. Also, last thing about repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it makes you getting more and more health and wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا.
صدق الله العظيم وبلغ رسوله الكريم وجعلنا وإياكم من الصادقين. نسأل الله العظيم رب العرش الكريم أن يوفقنا للتوبة النصوح وأن يجعلنا من التوابين المستغفرين. إنا نسأل اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. Brothers, please don't forget masjid from your charities. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, one of these things to make sure that your repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepted, is paying charity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, come forward, please. Brother, come forward, please. ألا وصلوا وسلموا على نبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، فإنه هداكم بإذن الله تعالى إلى الصراط المستقيم، وامتثلوا لأمره تعالى. قال الله تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد، وارض اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن سائر الآل والصحابة والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك وكرمك وإحسانك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم عنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم اجعلنا من الغانمين في صلاتنا، الخاشعين المفلحين الذين تنهاهم صلاتهم عن الفحشاء والمنكر. اللهم اذقنا حلاوة الإيمان ولذة المناجاة والتغني بالقرآن. اللهم عظم قدر الصلاة في قلوبنا، واجعلنا من عبادك الركع السجود. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبداً ما أحييتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا على من عادانا، ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا، ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا، ولا مبلغ علمنا، ولا إلى النار مصيرنا. اللهم اشفِ مرضانا، وارحم موتانا، وعليك بمن عادانا، واختم بالصالحات الباقيات أعمالنا، وبلغنا مما يرضيك أعمالنا، واحشرنا يوم القيامة في زمرة نبينا وتحت لواء حبيبنا. آمين. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم، يرحمني ويرحمكم الله.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا
Please, brother, complete the corner, right corner here. And please make sure cell phone is off.
اعتدلوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض، وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله، فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء، والله على كل شيء قدير. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون، كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها، لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت، ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا، ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا، ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة